What's up guys, my name is ChrisAmaterasu and in today's video we are going to talk about DMRs. And before we begin, I wanted to tell you that I'm doing coaching sessions on Discord, so if you want to improve your gameplay and get more wins, maybe more ADR or kills, hit me up on Discord so we can discuss about your problem. First 15 minutes are free. Let's get into the video. When it comes to a proper choice of DMR, I wanted to give you my own experience as an everyday player. I play with these guns every day, I see what they can do, and I see people who play with other guns and I see how they fail. Basically, I want to rate these guns from worst to best, from best to worst, and here we come. At number 1 we have MINI14. I feel like it's the greatest gun of all time. It comes with in line with QBU when you play on sanhok. Each of these guns give you incredible recoil, basically none, so you can hit enemies really far away and basically you can spray them. Number 2, you have SLR. I only take SLR when I have a cheek pad. I can explain it. This is a very powerful gun, but with every power comes a great responsibility. This gun provides you a huge amount of damage, but also big recoil. So if you're a new player, I strongly suggest you to pick this gun if you don't have a MINI14, or if you have it, just stay with MINI or QBU. Also, I don't have sniper rifles in this guide, we'll talk about this in a different video, but I wanted to tell you that sniper rifles are bad. Please don't take them, especially if you have less than 3000 hours. You will just be useless to your team or give bad impact. And this was my top 2 DMRs. Other DMRs I try to evade, don't take. I take them when I don't have another gun to shoot people. And now, when you know which DMR you have to take, let's talk about ways you can train them. Basically, a DMR, if you want to use it properly, you need to think about 2 things. First of all, your flicking ability. When an enemy jukes you in a different way or run some strange directions, you have to flick your DMR, so hit those shots. Second of all, it's fragging and the ability to punish your recoil, because every DMR has the recoil and your crosshair eventually jumps up and down and you have to control it. How can you do this? You can watch how I warm up in the previous video, this will be in the description. And now let's focus on things we can do to improve our DMR skill. So basically, what you need to do to do this correctly. You need a full inventory of 5.56, M249, as well as MINI14, and then... Alright, so this is the box, it's called Jump School Parachute Training, you can find it right here. You basically come here and you press F right there, and then your character parachutes right. Let's talk about situation number 1. Imagine you are trying to combat a person who are, let's say, 200 meters away, and you need to kill him. Yes, you have to shoot for the head and you have to tap him 4, 3, or 5 times, depends on his armor, to kill him, but you don't have to forget about your offense. So always press Q and E to evade his shots, move a little bit, try to switch your positions and pick from the different angles. Train this, you will go to a training center and you will spray, you will shoot behind the target. So you will stay behind it and you can just, let's say, press E, shoot a target and then come back to the cover so you don't get hit in the head, and you have to repeat it really fast so you can see it on the screen. And situation number 2 is when you just have to track your opponent and predict his movements and just shoot a little bit in front of him. To do this properly, I suggest you to just play a lot of PUBG games, and the tracking abilities and game sense will come to you as you play more and more and more. The only thing I can recommend you to tracking is to use Kovac Aim Trainer, link will be in the description. This is basically a game that helps you to warm up as well as to train your in-game skills if you have the same sensitivity. And that is that for today's video. Let's sum everything up. Number 1, pick only MINI14 MINI14 QBU, and if they are not available, pick SLR. If SLR and MINI14 are not available, pick something like an SKS. If SKS is not available, try to take Mutant. If Mutant is not available, try to take BSS, but stay away from Sniper Rifle. This is a bad choice. Number 2. Warm up properly and warm up your DMR before you hop onto the game. Try to use this mountain trick as I've showed you right now, and try to use different scopes so you can get to more situations. I hope you've liked this video, and if you do, leave a like, click the subscribe button, and click the bell button. This will help me drastically. Also, in the comment section down below, write down how do you warm a DMR, what is your favorite DMR, and write down what do you want to see next. Wish you good luck. ChrisAmaterasu out.